Just days after the Israeli military killed 7 aid workers from the World Central Kitchen, Benjamin Netanyahu is now demanding that not only the US continue sending weapons to Israel, but that they do so faster than ever before. Right now, a delegation of House Republicans is in Jerusalem. They're there for a meeting that was set up by AIPAC, talking with Benjamin Netanyahu. And here is what he told House Republicans. I have three messages for you. The first is we're going to win. Absolutely. Victory is within reach. It's very close. And there is no substitute for victory. The second is that it can be made quicker. I'll paraphrase someone you all have heard before, Winston Churchill. He said, give us the tools and we'll do the job. Give us the tools faster and we'll finish the job faster. I'm talking about the supplemental. I hope you find a way to give it as fast as you can. The third thing is there is a contrary move, an attempt to force, ram down our throats a Palestinian state, which will be another terror haven, another launching ground for an attempt, as was the Hamas state in Gaza. So he obviously wants more of the aid and he wants it expedited. He wants it to never end. And here is the current state of roughly what has been given thus far. So the US typically provides about $3.8 billion in military aid to Israel on a yearly basis. Since this conflict, they've also rushed multiple emergency shipments of weapons, totaling more than $250 million since October 7th. And recently, Biden authorized the transfer of over 1,500 pound bombs and over 1,000 small diameter bombs to Israel. And we're gonna turn to what Biden is, what he's saying to imply that things have become more tense between him and the leadership of Israel. But I wanna start there for just a little bit, because when you hear about 1,500 pound bombs being transferred to Israel, which has a perfectly well-equipped and well-trained domestic military and domestic arms industry, that they need these in particular, I just wanna remind people of one thing. You need 500 pound bombs to take out enemy fortifications, bunkers, tanks, things like that. There are none of those in Gaza. All there are buildings, hospitals, residential buildings, apartments, World Central Kitchen, aid vehicles. What exactly do you need 500 pound bombs for to take out a military, if you can even call what Hamas had or has that, that is constituted of individuals with assault rifles, IEDs, 500 pound bombs? Okay, I mean, look, a lot of the infrastructure of Gaza has already been leveled. Is it any wonder when munitions of this sort are being used? In any event, that's what's already been granted. And that's not what's being requested now by Benjamin Netanyahu. It is a whole nother round of weapons and aid. And it remains to be seen if Biden, well, certainly the Democrats or the Republicans are gonna support that. But will Biden make good on it? He's implying that there's this new rift following the aid worker's death. We'll have to see what that's worth in the end.
Yeah, nonsense, there's no rift at all. Let me break this down a little bit. So let's be honest, my prediction came true, but let's also be honest that it wasn't hard. And all of you predicted it along with me. The only people who can't predict it is everyone in Washington. Why did we predict exactly what would happen? Because we've seen it happen 20 other times. So Biden pretends that he's upset at Netanyahu and leaks, there was a tense phone call, stern words were exchanged, etc. You've seen this pattern 100 times, anybody can predict this. Then Netanyahu comes out and goes, shut up, I'm not gonna do anything you say, and send me money right now, okay? And that's exactly what happened. Okay, now in this case, it wasn't a press conference for Netanyahu. Instead, he went and talked to these 15 Republicans. But the nerve on this guy, like he talks to the president of the United States. If the president isn't 100% lying, I actually think that they probably play out the theater on the call just in case those calls are recorded, etc. And Biden goes, wags his finger. Okay, I'm really, being very upset at you. What are the words I'm supposed to use? Yeah. Okay. And then then Netanyahu went to the Republicans and said to them, no, send me the weapons quicker. I already gave you your orders. Why are we still having a conversation? Okay, so now if you get super upset about that, like, hey, you can't say that about Netanyahu, you can't say it about Israel. You can say it about any other country and any other leader, but you're not allowed to say it about, you're wrong, I just said it. So there's nothing you could do about it because it's absolutely true and we all see it with our own eyes. So when people in Washington keep saying, you cannot say things that are true, things that are obvious to literally everyone, sorry, We do truth on this network, okay? So if you're wondering why the Republicans having a meeting with Netanyahu, and this is a very unpopular position for Biden. Earlier in the week, we showed you a poll from the Wall Street Journal and the CNN anchors flipping out over it. And this issue alone might cost Biden the election, right? So because he's supporting Israel 100% when he shouldn't be, and the voters are ready to punish him for that. So Republicans shouldn't want any part of this. And you saw it with abortion. The minute Dobbs came out and abortion became an unpopular issue for the Republicans, they dropped it like a hot potato, right? All of a sudden, everybody's on TV going, Kellyanne Conway, Karl Rove, Sean Hannity yesterday. Don't talk about abortion. And abortion, look, we don't need 6 weeks. We don't even need 15 weeks. I mean, two-thirds, you know, maybe the first two trimesters is fine. That's Roe, right? So you see how quickly they dropped it when it was politically disadvantageous. But now the Republicans are going to go grab that hot potato. Why would they do that? So let's show you why they would do that. Let's go ahead to graphics 6 and 7 here. These are the contributions that those 15 Republicans have gotten from AIPAC. So pro-Israel groups have given to each Republican there. Oh, poor Eli Crane, shao, only $500, right? But as you go through, you see all the numbers here, 12,000, 13,000, 15,000. Show me the next one, they only get larger. 16,000, 22,000, 36,000, 46,000, 67,000, 270,000, and the list goes on and on. That's why they take the meeting. Ted Cruz, a huge advocate for Israel. Guess who his number one donor is? AIPAC. Speaker Mike Johnson says $14 billion not enough for Israel. We need to get them $17 billion, even though he's purposely punching himself in the face politically. Why would he do that? His largest donor, AIPAC. And who's the number one recipient of AIPAC money? Joe Biden. Interesting. And you might think, well, that's because he's president, etc. We're going to talk more about it later in the show. No, it's not because he's president. He broke the record for how much campaign donations anybody got from AIPAC when he was in the Senate. In US Senate history, no one has ever gotten more legalized bribes, what they call campaign contributions, than Joe Biden. $5.7 million. When you include the presidency, $11.2 million. How is this not mentioned in every single story about Joe Biden's motivations when it comes to policy on Israel? Is every reporter in the country genuinely saying that they don't think an $11 million in contributions affects a politician? Go ahead, I dare you. If you're a national media reporter, I dare you to say that on air, okay? Because you will lose all credibility with every normal person in the country. Instantly, no one believes that politicians are not influenced by their top donors. So that is why Biden pretends to yell at Netanyahu. Then Netanyahu, so brazen, comes out and slaps him around in front of the whole world, and then goes to Republicans and says, now you do it, as if he owns the place and runs the place. And partly because of AIPAC, he does. And if that hurts your feelings, go take it up with AIPAC. Mondale.
Yeah, the breakdown on that was unbelievable. Listen, here's the truth of the matter. A couple things that can be true. First of all, wow, on the $11 million. How long do you have to be president to make that money? Like, what president is making, what, $500,000 right now? So you have to be president 20 years to get that much money? That is unbelievable to me. The fact that our political system allows that much money to politicians that are making policy. Of course that money has a place in what Joe Biden is feeling and his politics, for sure. No one needs to argue that. But what's disgusting to me is Benjamin Netanyahu, who is a thug on all levels, who is responsible in part to Hamas having the ability to attack Israel on October 7th. This is what's disgusting to me. The fact that he can go and talk to Americans, Republicans, about who can and can't have a nation and what Israel will not stand for. He said victory is in reach. 33,000 people have been murdered in Palestine since October the 7th. 33,000. What do you mean by in reach? How close are you to completely wiping out everybody in Palestine and Gaza? I'm pissed off that nobody is talking about how much life. Over 100 journalists have been killed, 200 aid workers have been killed, and now we see the direct targeting targeting of aid workers by his military, and then they just do two people as scapegoat and fire them, and then the story will pass. And he goes on national TV with Republicans and the backing of so many other people, AIPAC and others, to say, yeah, America's president is nothing because we control the narrative. We, and what you have out of the MAGA right now, because they're all MAGA, you have one thing happening that is true. Whatever the money says will be the case. You can sell Bibles. You can make Jerusalem a part of Israel. Donald Trump did that. And you can actually say the Constitution is not real. You can say people attacking our state house, the country's house, the seat of democracy, are hostages. Not terrorists, but hostages. So I just know that Benjamin Netanyahu is about to get more 500-pound bombs to bomb away everyone that is living in Gaza. I promise you he will. And it will happen with speed, without haste.
Yeah, let me say a couple of things real quick about that. The 500-pound bombs that you guys are mentioning are devastating. But they also use 2,000-pound bombs. And we're going to talk more about this later on the show. It's a different story. But their kill ratios that are allowed, Guardian just broke this story, is if it's a low-level militant and they're not even sure that it's a militant, you're allowed to kill 20 civilians. If it's a militant leader, you're allowed to kill 100 civilians. If we found out that Hamas said, hey, in order to get one IDF soldier, let's just murder 20 Israeli civilians, we would say they were the worst terrorists in the world. But Israel does it, and the Republicans and Democrats are competing over how to send them money quicker, right? And just to be clear, the $11.2 billion is over the course of his career in campaign contributions. The 5.7 is in the Senate, and the rest is in when he was running for the White House and at the White House. Again, if you think that he's not affected by that because he's an angel, you sound like a moron, to be honest with you. So go ahead and say that all you want. And so I think that these guys just trying to figure out how do we get them more money to kill more people while pretending to be the good guys and Western democracy, etc. It's absurd, it's disgusting. The politicians tripping over themselves to compete for who's gonna serve them better. It's, one more thing on that, guys. It's kind of humiliating for all of us here in America.
Yeah. I mean, and Netanyahu is so arrogant with it. He's quoting Churchill in a war that 2 million people died. So you're telling us what you're willing to do to get rid of Gaza and prevent it from being a state.
Yeah, and in closing, he also says that we can get it done faster. When already the pace of civilian deaths is without precedent in modern conflicts. Not Afghanistan, not Iraq, not Syria, which was bombed by an entire handful of world powers. We've never seen civilians dying at the pace that they are. And he's saying we need to speed up on this thing. And it doesn't seem like that's being driven by military strategy. It seems like it's being driven by growing global opposition to the strategy that's being already pursued.
I want to give last word to one of our members. History Speaks wrote in on Super Chat. Of all wars in the 2020s, 2010s, 2000s, and 1990s, no government killed civilians at a faster rate per month than Israel is in Gaza. With the exception of the Second Congo War, deadliest war worldwide since World War II, and recognized genocides like Rwanda. So with those two exceptions, it is the fastest rate of killing civilians of any conflict in that time period. And he's right about that. And he thank you for reminding me of that. I love doing the show with members. Hit the join button below if you can to be a Young Turks member, to do it with us, etc. But for him to say we're gonna do it quicker, why is he saying that? Joe Biden just told him, do not go into Rafah and do a blitzkrieg, excuse the word, but kind of true, and kill more civilians. He gets off the phone, goes to the Republicans and say, yeah, I'm gonna ignore that loser that you have as a president, okay? And so I'm now ordering you guys, I'm gonna do it even faster. And why? Because Trump told him to do it faster. Kill more people at a quicker rate. All done with American taxpayer money. You paid any taxes at all, a portion of that went to go murder Palestinians on behalf of Netanyahu. 33,000 dead already. They claim that some portion of that is Hamas. Wait till you get the real facts later in the show and you find out what they call people Hamas is basically almost all males in Gaza, right? The adult males. But even so, 23,000 at a minimum are women and children that have been incinerated in those bombs that we paid for. And then he goes around literally adding insult to injury as he mocks our leaders and orders them around. If you're comfortable with that, have at it, Hoss, but I am not. That is not what America is supposed to be about. And this is deep, deep-seated corruption.
What do you mean, Cenk? That's America first, ain't it?
Well, isn't that hilarious? No, that's right. And but you know what, Mondale, a lot of the right wing base now, I've seen it for the first time starting to turn on this idea. Mm-hmm. Because I'm seeing it all over social media. I'm even seeing it by some of their leaders going, wait a minute, what are we doing? We said America first, but it doesn't look like America first. It looks like at best America second, okay? So the reason that kind of language sometimes makes people uncomfortable is because I get it. There's the old anti-Semitic tropes about Jews secretly control the world, etc. That is not true. But if you think that lobbyists don't control politicians, you're a moron, okay? That is definitely true. It's true for AIPAC, it's true for Raytheon, it's true for ExxonMobil, it's true for Pfizer. It's and all these guys get legalized bribes. And if you say because of old anti-Semitic tropes, I am never going to tell the truth to the audience. Sorry, that's dumb. No, explain what the tropes are, why they're wrong, then explain why lobbyists actually get everything they want. It just so happens, including AIPAC. And by the way, last thing, AIPAC says they're in this election cycle, they're gonna spend $100 million. Ooh. Is there really any reporter stupid enough to say that politicians don't care about $100 million in bribes headed in their direction? Yeah. Go ahead, say it, I dare you. That's how you lost all credibility in this country. Of course, AIPAC is the number one reason why we have an Israel policy that is unchecked and unconditional, no matter what they do.
Thanks for watching the Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun, but you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.